to the Bounce Fans Podcast.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Bot Squad Podcast. We are at episode number 66, right?
Man, and 66. 66.
Right? One more. But welcome to the Bot Squad Halloween Spectacular.
Spectacular.
Anyway. So, before we get right into the biggest thing that we're going to talk about today, which is The Walking Dead, what are we drinking today, John?
No, you do that. You got this. No,
what are we drinking right now?
As of right now, St. Arnold's Art Car. Again, like last time, we decided to have a beer a little earlier.
Beforehand?
Yeah, and it worked because it got David to have an extra beer because he tends to not drink his beers when we talk. So he's catching up on one, and this works right now. So right now
we're drinking St. Arnold's
Art Car. Yeah, it's an IPA. Really good. We've had it before.
This other beer here is from Freetail Brewing Company, and it's October Fiesta. Looks cool. I mean, that's kind of like the reason I got it, just because the outside looked cool.
I've had this on Botella form.
Oh, really? Is it good? Botella means bottle. So we're going to try this out next, and you've had it before. You weren't completely sold on it.
No.
So we'll see if maybe can makes a difference.
No.
So we'll see. Hey, we'll see. Sometimes it does.
We can recycle and get about 6 pennies back.
Cool. That sounds good. all right, so first up, again, like I said, before we start going into The Walking Dead, I wanted to talk a little bit about Alien Covenant, which is the sequel to Prometheus.
Okay.
And There have been some set photos coming out and stuff like that. To me, already, right off the bat, they should have called it maybe like Prometheus Covenant. Because it's like a sequel to Prometheus.
Yeah.
You know, I think they just changed it to Alien just to capitalize on the other movies. You know what I mean?
Or then they didn't do that with Prometheus.
Well, I know. Because they were going to keep it just that movie, and that was it.
So then, yeah, then just keep it.
Okay. Yeah. Right. So some new set photos came out, and this is kind of like of production stuff, some behind the scenes. I guess you could say like some of the effects that they were doing for the movie, and we have here the alien eggs, the pods here, and this is coming from soisitanygood.com. So. Obviously, right off the bat, you're seeing, you know, they're going to be bringing in the aliens, the xenomorphs themselves, you know, and the headhuggers and stuff like facehuggers.
I haven't seen those.
So, this looks like the ship from the Prometheus film. Looks like maybe like the main, like the middle, I guess, battle station area. You know what I mean?
But look, the eggs are like the slits go down further.
Yeah, they're a little different.
Yeah. Well, of course, it's like they tend to change a little bit more and more.
They're evolving them. They're evolving the look or de-evolving the look from what we know.
Yeah.
What I mean? They're taking it back to something a little bit more primitive and stuff like that.
Like Star Wars, they made everything look cool.
And then next, we actually have a look at a xenomorph.
Oh, wow, I didn't see that.
Now, this xenomorph, though, has like half teeth, like regular teeth, it looks like.
Okay, so they're going with that crap.
From this part, for some odd reason, it reminds me of an engineer. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The look of it, the style of the face, kind of reminds me a little bit like of an engineer. Which, it looks cool already right there as it is. And that looks like it's going to be a big fucking head.
Or,
you know what I mean?
Big fucking alien.
And then the next one, we get a look at a small evolution of the xenomorph here. So you have over here on the bottom left is the one from Prometheus at the end.
Mm-hmm.
One with a pointy, you know, a pointy head. And then you have something that looks a little smaller. The head is not as long, but it's rounded at the end.
Yeah.
And then the next one right next to it, it looks like is a bit bigger, and then the head is a little longer. And then you have the head that we just saw, which looks freaking huge compared to all the other ones. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I wonder if they're going to give us a look at, like, some of the change, I guess, you know, of how it's going to evolve into
that's pretty cool.
What we know. Next up, and this tripped me out, right?
Uh-huh.
This picture shows a face hugger. That is a huge face hugger.
Whoa.
That's like a body hugger.
It is. Wait.
I don't know if...
Is there anything near it to like compare it to?
There's some skulls.
Oh, whoa.
At the bottom.
That is huge.
So that's huge, man. So, yeah, I mean, it's pretty insane how they're taking it or where they're going with this.
Yeah, and it's going down.
And I'm going to assume that maybe they're going to... they're going to show, you know, maybe how they evolve and get more, I guess, well, they're going to go in opposite directions, it seems like, because the facehuggers, if they're going to start like that big, then they're going to show how they, you know, start going into a smaller scale.
Yeah.
And then the aliens, how they're going to show how they started out small and then start getting into, like, what we know.
Well, I mean, the only thing I can think of is that the engineers were huge, man.
The engineers were huge.
They were huge.
They were at least, like, I don't know, 8 feet tall?
Yeah, they're something up there, like that. 10.
They're like Undertaker? Or something. Or no. What's that that one wrestler's name? The one with the hairy outfit.
Hairy outfit?
Yeah. He had like a hairy tights on, but he was freaking big, man. He fought the Undertaker, WrestleMania.
Tall, skinny 10. Dude?
Kind of skinny. Oh, Giant Gonzalez. Literally, his like tights, his outfit... He looked like Bigfoot. Like, he had hair, like, fur and stuff coming down on his arms, and it was weird. Anyway, getting off track here. But yeah, so, I'm actually, you know, I'm pretty excited to see where they're going to go, because apparently Ridley Scott still has, like, 2 more Alien movies planned.
Really?
Before they connect it to the main Alien franchise.
Isn't that weird how that's going about? Because when Prometheus was coming around, he was like, no.
Yeah.
This is not an Alien movie.
Yeah.
He's like, don't tie it in and blah, blah, like, blah.
The aliens aren't going to be in it. It's going to be very loosely, you know, even a part of it. You know, it's not an Alien movie. And then it was so successful. And that's still a movie to this day.
Good.
I can watch, like, over and over. I've at least probably watched it about 10 times in total.
I watched
maybe more.
Maybe 3, maybe 4 times.
I watched it like 2 or 3 times at the movies.
Yeah. Oh, I remember you saw it in 3D.
Yeah. Because I wanted to understand it. It was so philosophical and stuff like that. It was so crazy.
The same way. I think he saw it like 100,000 times.
Yeah. But great movie. Great movie. I wish that they would have continued the Prometheus name with it, because it is part of Prometheus. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it should be, yeah.
Like Prometheus, and then Prometheus such and such, and then Prometheus such and such, and then into Alien, or like Prometheus Aliens.
Revenge.
with the vengeance.
With an alien like down the cover.
So, anyway, so we're going to go ahead and start getting into our main, like, topic of the day. This is the big topic, and we had to talk about it. We really did. I mean, we've had a week to decompress from what happened on The Walking Dead. And, so, I mean, let's go ahead and just jump right in and just pick this shit apart, man. Like, seriously, I stayed up about 2 nights ago, something like that, and I watched the episode about 2.5 times. And I was picking apart certain scenes, and I was just like, oh, my God. So, the season 7 premiere happened just last Sunday.
Yeah.
We have a new episode coming out this Sunday. If you're listening to us now, not live, then it came out yesterday.
Yeah, it came out.
the new episode. So, it starts off, you know, pretty much where we left off. The group is still on their knees. Negan... we actually, you know, I'm sorry, it's they are on their knees, but we see the scene that we took apart the last time. Where, you know, you see blood across Rick and all that stuff, and he's giving them that whole right-hand man speech and da-da-da, and then it ends with him dragging him into the RV and taking off.
I might come back with Rick.
I might not. Yeah.
I'm here to keep going.
No.
Jerk left me up the hang.
But yeah, so, and then from there he takes him on a ride and has his talk with him, you know? Yeah. And they keep kind of flashing back, and he, you know, Negan, you really get to see who Negan is in this episode. And I'm, man,
the dude,
he's twisted, man.
You know, I was hoping they wouldn't go that with that damn angle, that Rick angle. You remember when Rick was losing his mind and everything, and he was doing that whole lost shit. And he was doing it again in this one. And like David mentioned with Negan, Negan reminded me sometimes of football teams. You know, when you go in there, like let's say in the beginning of the game, and you start dominating and you just start, you have a high score. Let's say if the other team is at zero and halftime comes around, you don't have to make another point, but you do it anyway. To me, that's driving a dagger in and pushing that son of a bitch in further.
That is a good analogy. I like that.
When I saw Neil, I was like, oh my God, this dude, you know?
Yeah. Like, and the way he spoke was so, like, natural. Like, he was just, like, there, like, hey, what's up, you know? And then there was a moment where he was like, I'm going to give you one more chance. And he opens the door to the RV and chunks the axe on top of the RV. He said, go get my axe. And then you see Rick just like just kind of stewing, letting it stew.
Boom.
And then you see Negan just get up close. And his eyebrows go straight. He said, go get my axe. And I'm like, oh, shit. Like, you see what kind of guy Negan really is, you know? Like, he can smile at you and crack jokes. And, yeah, he's still going to be an asshole. And then he just went, like, it's like, there you see how mad he can really get. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And Jeffrey Dean Morgan fucking just killed it, dude.
He owned it, man.
He just, like, is that character now. I love it. And then, you know, Rick goes out. He fights through the zombies. And he basically chunks them out there into a group of zombies. Walker, I'm sorry.
Kicked his ass right
and
boom.
and he fights his way up to the top of the RV, and there's the axe. And he starts to, you know, remember. Negan starts telling him, remember, you know, what can happen if you don't.
Processing all the bullshit that happened.
And he lays down, and he starts, it's basically a flashback to what we didn't see right before the episode started.
And we still don't get an answer of what happened.
Yeah. And you know what? It was killing me. Yeah.
They did a damn good job. It
was killing me.
They did a damn good job.
I don't think that I've felt that way about a show before, where I could feel my heart was pumping.
What?
Like, yeah, my heart was pumping. I was like, come on, like, show me who it is,
right.
You know?
Hey, you know what? Okay, all right. I had to step out, so I paused it, and I was barbecuing, so I had to step out and go, you know, and go tend to it. And when I came back, you David texted me, and David was like, something happened, because I was like, I was already kind of at the point where I was thinking, you know what? They're probably going to show what happened at the very end. And apparently, they showed. And David already had seen it, so he texted me, and I was kind of like weary to read it.
Man, you shouldn't have.
I don't
think I gave anything away.
No, you didn't. You know, he didn't give anything away. He technically, don't say anything on our Facebook page, the Boss Bar Podcast Network.
Oh yeah, that's right.
He was, because you know, you don't want to ruin it for anybody. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Because I could just hear it already. If we would have posted something, people would have been like unliking the page and saying something.
Even if we waited one day, you know what I mean? So
yeah, even the day after, 2 days after, I was still kind of like, you know about it.
Fuck Thursday. I had people like, no, I haven't seen it. Anyways, so he texted me, then I read it, and I was like, something happened. God, I was like, damn, let me flip this damn hot dog real quick.
He grabs him.
I went back inside. I'm trying to watch it.
Baby, gotta turn on the Walking Dead. Let daddy watch his stories.
Anyways, something had happened, okay? And they didn't feed us that whole Rick losing his mind thing, but they did give us a run for our money, because they showed a lot of stuff that it had you guessing, because they kept showing
other people. They kept showing like little flashbacks of everybody, and I was like, oh man, they're like putting the icing on the cake right now, because they're like who is it, guys? Who is it? It could be anybody, showing all the past memories of all the other, you know, seasons of their character. And then, you know, he remembers, and he starts going back, and it's right where he starts, you know, doing the eeny, meeny, miny, moe. And, you to that moment, I'm like, who is it? Who is it? Again, on this show, I had, you know, made it a point to make my pick months ago. And I was kind of flip-flopping in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And I was kind of like, well, it could be Daryl and da-da-da-da. And then I was like, okay, you know what? I have to make a pick. I'm going to stick to it no matter what. And I made my pick, and that was it. Right? So he's doing the Eeny, Meeny, Miny, Moe. And then right at the very end, he picks Abraham. And I was like, oh, shit.
And you notice he was still...
And right when he picks him, Abraham's just like, all right, I'm doing it. He stands up straight, and he throws up those two fingers. He throws up those two fingers, chunking a deuce, to Sasha, as you can see right there. And that's when she's like, oh, like she starts crying even more. And then he's like facing the fact. You know, you get a close-up of his eyes, and then we see the first hit. And he takes it, and...
He takes it, and then taking
it like a champ.
Like a champ.
And then what does he say right before this second hit, though? Suck my nuts. And I laughed, man. I laughed because I was like, that's a total Abraham way to go out.
Yeah.
I was like, that's a total Abraham way to go out. I was like, if he had to be the one to go out, I was like... Perfect way.
You know what they said? I don't know if it was on the Talking Dead or whatnot. They technically they said that they didn't like, and this sucks. It sucks to say this about, you know, the original person who made The Walking Dead, was that they didn't like a strong character like that to go out like that.
Yeah.
So what they did is instead of having him die on the fucking railroad tracks and shit with the arrow to the back of the head and the eyeball, they wanted to give him a badass
death. A better ending, you know?
Because a powerhouse character like that, he had to go out like
now,
that.
Now, it sucks because I do wish that he would have stuck around. I think he would have been a great character to have stick around. He's powerful. He's a powerful dude, you know? But if he had to go, that was the best way for him to go.
Yeah,
you know, to even after that first whack, still say, suck my nuts.
Yeah.
You know? And then, Negan, you know, whacks him again. Ooh. And then he just keeps going. He keeps going. And then Negan speaks up. He's like, did you hear what he said? He said, suck my nuts. And then he keeps wailing on him until he's a bloody mess with no head, basically. And... that was pretty, like, wow. Like, they showed that. Yeah, like, yeah. I mean, Walking Dead shows a pretty good amount of gore.
Or, like, when they do, like, a boot kill, but it's like, and real quick.
See, but it's mostly to dead things.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Not a person.
To have something so gory, so bloody happen to an actual cast member was like, whoa, dude.
Push it to the limit.
But it was cool, though, right?
Yeah, it was.
And and then right after that, you see everybody crying, everybody's freaking out, especially Sasha and Rosita.
Rosita, yeah.
Rosita's like in shock, from what I could tell. And Negan walks up to her with a bloody bat. He was like, look. He's like, oh, yeah. what did he say?
He goes, were you and him
together?
Together.
Man! And then, the best line, I had to write it down, the best line that I will forever remember to this day is, I had to write it down, I'm serious. He goes, red? He goes, and hell, he was, is, and will ever be red.
Yeah.
He just took one or six or seven for the team. I was like, oh man, that is a badass line right there though. Where, he
destroyed his ass.
God, man, he just, like, wrecked it. I'm going to wreck it. And then after that, Daryl, like, injured or not, has had enough.
Yeah.
Gets up, and as soon as I saw that, I was like, I thought for a second, I was like, oh, maybe my pick is wrong. Because my first pick was Abraham. So I was right. about that, right? And I was like, ooh, maybe my other pick is wrong. And Negan gets up and clocks Negan. Daryl gets Daryl up and clocks up, Negan in the face. And when that happened, I was like, oh, bad move, dude. Bad move.
I know, dude. I mean, he was already coming down from his speech and everything, talking about, you know, he took it for 6, 7, 8 of you guys, and all of a sudden this happens, you know?
Yeah.
And he's like, no, no, no.
And then, yeah, he pretty much says, you know, says it. He's like, I'm, you know, I meant it when I said it, that I'm going to shut that shit down.
Mm-hmm.
And he starts giving this big old speech.
Dude, I knew it.
And as soon as he walked to that side,
dude,
and you see Glenn on the side, I'm like, I was singing out loud. I was like, it's Glenn next.
Really?
Glenn's next. Yeah, I was sitting right there on the couch. I was like, Glenn's next. Everybody was watching the damn TV. And they're like, no. I was like, Glenn's next.
I knew when he gave him his back, I knew it was gonna happen.
Yeah,
I had company over, and my kids and my wife and everything, we're all watching it, and I'm like, when I saw that, I was like, and I started doing this, cause that's what we do. Like whenever we throw, if you ever throw a sledgehammer, what you'll do is you'll put your arm into it and you sway around.
But
and I saw, I was like, this dude,
you saw a slight pick of that, but not much. Like, he didn't really wind up too much. I could see it, that they were going more of a surprise, because there was three people. You know, I kept saying, it's Glenn. Glenn's going to be the second one. I was like, but for all I know, the way his body language was, I was like, he could have easily rotated in any way and whacked the hell out of, you know, the people that were in line.
Excuse me.
And then, of course, what happens? First hit, Glenn. Turns around, straight back. Wax Glenn in the head. And already, man, I was like, oh my god. It was one of those moments where, like, okay, I was like happy because I was right, and I was happy that they kept Glenn in there because it was straight from the comics.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I was like, I wish I wasn't right. Yeah. You know what I mean? I wish it didn't happen that way. Because it sucks. I mean, Glenn's character was happy, and that's but that's the thing. When you're happy in the world of The Walking Dead,
you gotta go.
Shit happens, you know.
And, you know what? And this goes to show you how big and badass what's his name was, the redhead,
Abraham.
The dude took a whack and was
sucked. He was able to talk.
Yeah, and Glenn took a whack
and they were doing it that way. Because that's kind of how it happened in the comics.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where he was like, and then he screamed out Maggie. In this case, he started, well, that was the outcome of that first hit.
Yeah.
You see his eye bulging out just like in the comics. I mean, it's a little tough to see. I was like, oh, shit.
In the comic, it was actually hanging.
It was like hanging out.
Hanging, yeah.
And then Negan says, obviously, it's straight from the comics. He's like, whoa, you took a hell of a hit. He was like, your eyeball's even hanging out of your head. And it's gross as shit. I was like, oh, man. And then, of course, you know, he bashes him until there's nothing. And you see his hand just twitching at that time, too. But right before that, again, Negan says this one line. Again, I had to write it down because it was good. Where he goes, oh, hell. He's like, I can see this is hard on you guys. I am sorry. Like, I truly am. But I did say it. No exceptions. And then that's when he turns around and whacks him again until he's bloody like that. And, you know, and honestly, I kind of felt like Negan was being, like, genuine.
Yeah.
You know, but he was like, I told y'all, like, you know, I said what was going to happen.
Yeah, shut that shit down.
Y'all fucked up,
yeah.
So I was like, man, you know, that was one moment I was like, man, again, Negan's going to have a lot of these lines, you know.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure he has a shit ton of good ones.
Memorable lines, and these were two of the ones that I thought were perfect for this episode. I mean, what did you think about that whole scene as a whole, though? It was Abraham and Negan.
Like, what do you mean? Like, it was just, it was right. I mean, well, on our last, one of the last, I can't remember which podcast was it.
I
don't know.
I can't remember. We talked about The Walking Dead.
It made sense. It made sense. It made perfect sense. And I think it was played out really good, man, for Abraham to go. You know, and he never, no, because he stood up before that. He never kneeled down. He never, everybody was sitting on their ass. If they were on their legs, they were on their knees. Abraham went up and he stayed up.
Yeah.
And when he finally got to him, he was still up. And he was just like, it's your ass.
And, you know? And if you go back and watch the season finale, it's like you already knew going into it, you know, that Abraham was going to be the one. Because, again, it made sense what we talked about. Like you were saying, it was like, you know, he's the one that, like, sat up straight and was like, give it. Like, yeah, come on. I'm not going to back down from you. And, of course, on Negan's end, it's like, okay, well, you know what? Either, whatever way he was picking any, meeny, miny, mo, he probably already knew who he was going to get.
I think he was happy that it was him.
Because of what he did. Because of him trying to, like, show off and whatever.
And the whole thing, though, I loved it all. After Abraham took it, and when he turned his back to Glenn, and then Glenn took it, I was happy. Everything that was said, the way it was done, the way it was shot, the blood, everything, it was all great. I think they gave us an awesome episode.
The drama was all there. The intensity. Mm-hmm. I thought everybody gave awesome performances.
Like David mentioned earlier with the icing, with how they gave everybody the little memorable memories and all that stuff. Then they sprinkled this shit on top of it. After they gave us the cake, the icing, and we got sprinkles on it too, because they showed a real quick video of everybody getting hit with the bat. So you didn't know who the fuck was getting hit. You know what I mean? And then after that, man, they showed
everybody. Yeah, you know, and then that's the other thing, was that they showed, because they go back to Rick, and he's still in the RV or whatever, and Negan's telling him, you know, if you don't do what I tell you, if you don't comply basically what I'm telling you, you know, think about what's going to happen to everybody back there. And then they show little flashes of everybody getting hit with the bat.
Yeah.
Now, this makes sense because there was a report a while back that they were trying to hide who was being killed, and they were shooting everybody's death
scene. Yeah.
And I was like, okay, that makes sense. That's cool that they included it in the episode and not just did it just to hide things. You know what I mean?
That's why even the cast didn't know who was going to die,
yeah,
right?
Because they all filmed
it. They all died, yeah.
So I thought that was amazing. I love the way that they did that. I thought that was really cool storytelling, too, to include it in and where he was, like, in his own mind, he's thinking of everybody getting hit, you know, with the bat. And so the episode continues on. And, you know, they head back to where they were all kneeling down, right?
Yeah.
And throws Rick back out. And pretty much, there was a brief moment in the RV. I thought he was going to cut off Rick's hand.
Yeah.
I was like, are they really going to do it? I was like, oh, my God. But
they kept hinting?
Yeah, they kept hinting at it.
And that's what kept the show going, too, that nail biting as, because it didn't, as soon as it ended with Glenn getting it and then them leaving, it didn't end there because it was the whole hatchet thing, and then it was the whole hand thing. You know what I mean?
It was like up until that point when they got back to camp or whatever, and he threw him out to the middle of everybody. And by that time, it was already daylight, morning time, from what you could kind of tell. And it didn't really entirely click with me. I was like, this whole episode is in that one area. They're not leaving that area. You know, so I was like, wow, okay, cool. And then he tells Rick that, you know, it's a new day, and da-da-da. And they grab and throw Carl in the middle. And he tells that his right-hand man, Simon, he's like, you have a marker? Or you have a pin?
Pin, yeah.
And he goes, yeah. And he draws a line on Carl's arm and basically tells Rick, Rick at this point is like, no, please don't. He's like, please don't do it. He's like, me? He's like, I'm not doing shit. He goes, you're going to cut the boy's arm off or a hand off. And then that's where Rick starts losing it.
No.
Yeah, because
Negan tells him, he goes, you know what? I've showed it to everybody here. Technically, I've proven my point, what I can do and how I can do it.
Yeah.
And I see it in everybody's eyes here. The only one I don't see it from is you.
Yeah.
So we're going to change that.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
He wants to see that fear in Rick's face. Rick, to that point, even right before he threw him in the RV, was like, gave him that thing. I'm going to kill you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, not today, not tomorrow, but I will kill you.
He made the attempt to try to kill him, too. Yeah. And Negan, real quick,
Negan was telling him, grab the axe, you know? Anyway, so he wants to instill that fear in Rick, you know? And that moment where he's telling him, cut off Carl's arm, and even Carl was like, Carl wasn't even crying. He was like, just do it. And to me, that's a testament to Carl also. Cause up until maybe fairly recently, I always thought Carl was just like this throwaway character. Like, kill Carl already, man.
He's been redshirted by David.
Yeah, for a good while he was. But that kind of showed a different side to him. I was like, okay, he's kind of like taking it for the team. Like, he knows, like, if you don't do this, they're going to kill everybody.
Yeah.
So just do it already. Just get it over with.
And if this man right here don't cut off his arm, put a barrel up to everybody's head, and he goes, and even better, man, did even better. Make sure you point upward into the middle of the skull. So
you see a blast come out of the face in front of him.
He wants shit splattered on him.
I mean, this guy, like, he has it down to the T.
He's on point, man.
You know, he has every I dotted and every T crossed.
Yeah.
You know, and he wants to make a point. And he made it, you know, at this point, because Rick is crying his eyes out. And you know it got serious when you see the Rick snot bubble. You know? There was a big old, huge snot bubble that came out of Rick's face. And the way he was crying was something that I had never heard Rick cry like that before. I had never heard anything like that from him. No, you know, like that kind of, like, it was so strange.
But then that, you know what, if there's a part of me that says that maybe that was just a good that was him act.
Oh no, yeah. Well, you see. And here it comes too. I guess here goes my thought process also, because spoiler alert for people that have not read the comics, because there is a point in the comics where after this happens, he tells Negan what he wants to hear, and then they go back, and he's telling everybody else, like, you know, Negan owns us now.
Yeah, which you've already seen in the new trailer. We are,
yeah. That same exact scene, he says that, and then he goes and he confides in one person, which is, I think it was Andrea in the comics.
Yeah, she's still alive.
Yeah.
In the comic.
And he tells her, like, he's like, I'm biding my time. He's like, I'm, you know, gonna do everything in the background. I'm just saying what needs to be said. I'm not even letting anybody else know what's going on. He's like, but we're gonna take him out.
Yeah.
At some point or another. And I think that's kind of what he's doing here, in a way. I mean, I'm sure it's emotional because it's your son.
Your kid, yeah.
You know, but I think at the same time, he's also giving him what he wants to hear. Because
he wants to hear it.
Next scene is of Rick just, like, looking scared, shitless, you know what I mean?
And there it is.
Yeah, and that's the scene there. I was like, oh, man. But And I guess what triggered also that thought process that you were saying also was that right after, you know, that happens, and basically they're left there, you know, Negan leaves him there to literally pick up the pieces.
Yeah.
You know, that Rick starts talking regular.
Yeah, right.
To Maggie.
Yeah.
Like, Maggie, you know, she's hurting. She's getting up. She's like, y'all need to go prepare. And then you don't see him crying anymore, and nothing that looked evident of tears or nothing like that, or that he was crying, and he's like, no, you need to, like, sit down, you know, you need to rest, you know, we'll worry about it. And his composure was different.
Yeah.
Than from what, like, was maybe a couple minutes ago, or, you know, minutes before. So that kind of triggered also, you know, something in me that he was just kind of giving him what he wants to hear. But yeah, so I thought this episode was freaking amazing.
Fucking awesome.
I mean, it ends pretty much with them there and picking up the bodies and going.
Yeah.
You know, at this point, it's pretty much is being hinted at or said that Maggie's heading to Hilltop, that other community.
Yeah, she, you know what, and that's where I thought that's where I knew it was going to happen, because, see, in the comics, if you guys don't know, the group splits, you know what I mean? Maggie goes that way, and, you know, Rick, you know, it stays in, with a different group, you know, and, then there's the, I thought there was going to be some type of, like, headbutting. Like, maybe she didn't like the way he did something.
See, I was waiting for that. I was like, oh, she's going to deck him. She's going to deck him.
Because he kept talking. Like, almost like he was kind of rambling.
But she kind of proved otherwise. She kind of proved that she was giving, like, this leadership you know, role. Like, we have to concentrate on what's the bigger picture here.
Glenn to die for me to act this way.
Yeah. Well, even before that, she was kind of like heading down that road little by little.
Because of, what's the name of that damn town I live in?
Alexandria.
Yeah, I was going to say Aventasia. Alexandria. Because of that other lady that was running that town. You know what I mean? She felt like she saw.
Yeah.
You know?
And when they went to the Hilltop to go visit that one time, she was the one that was talking to that dude Gregory.
Yeah.
You know, she was the one doing the negotiations. You know, not Rick.
Yeah.
Not anybody else. Because, you know, Rick would be like, we're taking your shit. He basically, honestly, the way I see it, is that...
He told her that too. He goes, don't send me in there.
It's like, honestly, and again, after watching this episode a couple times, and thinking about it, I'm like, Rick is no better than Negan.
Uh-huh.
Because... I mean, who are we to say that Negan is just not like the same person as Rick and just doing what he has to do to survive?
We just know Rick better.
Yeah, we just know Rick better because we've been following his story. I mean, if it would have been switched around and we would have been following Negan's story from the beginning, I bet you we would have been sympathetic towards Negan.
Fuck him and that Chinese dude that died, man.
Fuck that redhead guy.
The redhead guy. It's true. It's so true.
So, but I mean... I think we're going to see a bit more of that coming from Negan and more relatability between Rick and Negan later on, that they're kind of almost like the same person, you know, but Negan is a little bit more charismatic the way he does things. He's theatrical about it. Like, hey, what's up?
I love that, man. Like,
Lucille's a vampire bat.
Uh-huh. And you notice they kept that bat bloody as fuck.
Oh, man. Yeah. It was like dark red, man.
And when he flung it around,
and he had meat hanging off of it at some point.
Yeah, dude.
So, I mean, I thought they did a fantastic job with this episode. And I said from day one, when that finale happened, I'm like, just wait. Just wait. All the people that are pissed off, it's gonna, you know, people are gonna be satisfied. You know, and I don't think that they let anybody down. I know that there still are people that are disappointed.
Did you see, like, the YouTube videos of the people's reactions?
I saw a couple of them. Somebody was crying. I saw one with some dude was crying.
My little girl cried.
Oh, really? Yeah, she was, okay, how old is she?
13.
Okay.
She didn't believe that he was going to die. And then, because when I started to say, oh, he's going to get it. You know, I was like, it's going to happen. I was like, watch, you can see he's going to turn. I was telling my guest this. I was like, he's going to turn, boom. And my little girl was like, no.
No.
And then boom, she's like, and I saw her like tuck away, and what she did is she confined herself to her mom, and she was, you know, and then when I turned around, like, what?
I think what got me, I didn't cry or nothing, but man, it was sad. I texted you. I said, man, that was pretty sad, man.
Man, what?
Man, that's pretty sad, dude.
I'm a man. But I cried, because
I think what kind of got me was after the episode when they had the Talking Dead special.
Wow.
And they came out and you could hear Steven Yeun and Michael Cutlitz, the guy that played Abraham and Glenn, they were kind of starting to get choked up
as
they were talking, because it makes sense, dude. Like, these people are a family.
Yeah.
They are confined with each other for so long filming. They're like, you know, they see each other all the time, every day.
That's your job.
Yeah. And they hang out, they goof off, whatever. And then to have somebody, especially somebody like Glenn, that was there from essentially the second episode, but he was there in the first episode in voice.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Basically from the very beginning, like, go after 7 years. You know, I mean, it's a sad moment. I think that's what got me more so than the deaths on, you know, on the actual show.
Did you hear when they asked him, when they asked him, like, you know, like, well, you know, what do you think or whatever? And he was like, yeah, you know, you know, when you take a strong name like Glenn, when you have him go from being delivery boy to running around and scavenging and grabbing things to becoming one of the leaders of a big group.
Yeah, I mean, he went from that to a main guy.
You can even hear it in Steven Yeun's voice, like he was kind of like you, Steve. Like, he knew from the get-go, like, okay, you're going to be the character that's going to win everybody's heart.
Yeah.
And then you're going to die. You know, eventually, you know, at one point, your character's going to go. And you could see it in his face. Like, he was like, he shouldn't have gone. You know, he was saying it. Like, the heart for that group.
Yeah. He basically was the heart of the group. And he did say that he goes, I remember, he's like, we're working on the show. He's like, and I got issue 100. He's like, and I would read The Walking Dead before. He's like, so I was a fan of the comic. He's like, we got to issue 100. He's like, after reading it, I was like, whoa. You know, he saw the end, and I think he asked, Kirkman asked him, like, what'd you think? He's like, so it's fucked up. He's like, but it's so good. Like, he's like, I wouldn't want that death to go to anybody else.
Yeah.
He's like, you know, as hard as it is. And that, I think, I want to say that was like during season 3 or 4 or something like that. So, again, he had an inkling that it was coming for a while.
Yeah.
And apparently they had been planning these deaths for 2 years already.
Really?
Yeah. That he kind of said, like, as much as it sucks, as much as it's going to hurt, like, I wouldn't want to have that pivotal death go to anybody else. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He's like, I want it to be me, because honestly, after issue 100 in the comics, that story goes and branches off so many directions because of that moment. You know what I mean?
It does. It really does.
So, I mean, that's kind of telling you what's in store for The Walking Dead as a show, that it's just going to get bigger and bigger because of that moment, you know?
So we're not only going to just, I hope, if they do that, that means that we won't just see what we've been used to seeing,
yeah,
which is just the regular group. So we're going to see other groups and other stories, like how David mentioned. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and more things that come from it, like as far as people feeling a certain way or towards other people, things like that. Now, with Maggie not being the one that's mad towards Rick, I want to say that it could be somebody like maybe Sasha or Rosita.
Giving
the anger.
But towards Rick.
Yeah, towards Rick.
No, but why wouldn't anybody... Would anybody be mad at fucking Daryl?
Okay, you know what? Okay, I take that back. Yeah.
Because, I mean...
I think the anger will be directed at Daryl.
Because, like, he's the one that antagonized
him. And, you know, and I'm glad you brought that up, because I almost forgot. That was a point that I was trying to give. Was that...
Real quick.
What?
What do you think?
It's okay. It's all right.
That's all I'm saying.
You know, this beer, this October Fiesta, kind of, it has like a peanutty taste at the end of it.
They're trying to do the October Fest, but it's Fiesta okay. And whatever.
It's okay. I'll say that. So with the Glenn thing, I did have a point that I did want to, you know, put across, was that I think with that, because Daryl did what he did, Daryl's going to have this level of guilt in him.
Oh, yeah.
The entire way through. And with him, and then we didn't even mention that he got taken away with Negan's men.
As collateral, right?
So, I have this inkling that they're going to make Daryl so unlikable that they're going to, that whenever they do kill him, it's not going to hurt. Because you're going to be like, well, It's Glenn's fault. I mean, it's Daryl's fault that Glenn died.
All right. Hold on. I just thought of something.
So, right here.
No, not yet. Okay, because you guys have to understand that David's been right on actually, yeah, David and the podcast has pointed out a lot of things and fucking happened and it was said first.
Right, pretty much on the mark, said first
because I didn't hear it from anybody else. But first, right here on the Boxwell podcast. So he's made a lot of good points and a lot of the points have been true. Okay, here's another. Now, I heard that they were trying to get Daryl's homeboy from the Boondock Saints to be on the show.
That would be kind
of
cool.
Well, what if his homeboy was a part of... No. What if
he... Like, Daryl, you look different.
And he's like Irish and shit, just like that. What if his friend is part of Negan's group, and he's the one that takes him out?
See, that could be possible.
Like you said, they make everybody to hate... Everybody's... I'm sure everybody's point of view of Daryl right now has changed a little bit because of what he did.
Yeah.
To cause what happened to Glenn. So this softens the blow of getting rid of Daryl.
Yeah, and I think what could go even further in that direction would be if they reform Daryl and make him part of the Saviors, where Daryl's now like, you know, he's like, well, whatever, you know, I'm, or they brainwash him in a way where he's doing their bidding and he's doing these bad things, terrible things. And they have no way of killing, no reason but to kill him.
Like Winter Soldier?
Exactly. Because that red book. I couldn't even think of the words that they say, like...
17?
Freight train,
yeah.
Lobster. And
garbage can or something.
Waffle. I don't know.
And he's like, stop.
Like, I wanna fuck y'all.
Stop saying those words.
But anyway, so yeah. I mean, there's an opening there. Where I think that again, they're going to make Daryl very unlikable. And then to add to that, the guilt of, you know, him getting Glenn killed, basically. And I think they're going to off him by, I would say, next season.
Sign, seal, and approve that shit right now.
Boom, stamp.
So he's going.
I'd say by season 8, Daryl's dead. I would say. They're going to string it along this whole season and build up on that guilt and that bad situation, and then he's gone. Yeah,
he's gone, or he's like taking off.
No, he's gone. Because like,
I have this thing that to me, and this has something to do with like motorcyclists and stuff like that, and he is a motorcyclist, is that he seems to me as a lone wolf, and I have a feeling like he'll always be a lone wolf because he was brought up like that. And he seems to go in this world like that, and he's going to go out like that. I think
at the end... He's going to leave? He's going to pull a Carol and try to just take off?
Carol?
No, but... Carol!
Well, I think at the end of all this bullshit, like all the madness and everything, when the whole show ends or whatever, I think Daryl's going to be on his own. I think he's going to be the only one left, and like always left to be alone.
You think so?
Yeah. And that's how him and his motorcycle... Rick or whatever he calls
it. So I'm gonna ride Rick. Like, it's weird.
I'm gonna fill you up. Some unleaded gas. Then I'm gonna ride your ass all the way.
So do you think that it's a possibility that Daryl could be the last one standing after The Walking Dead is over?
Yeah.
Like at the very end? You think so?
Yeah. And you know what? I heard somebody on the show say something about Carl. How they mentioned that Carl was supposed to be the last one standing.
Yeah, well, it's all kind of speculation that they think that, you know, Carl could be the last one. Like, Rick handing over, you know, the leadership to Carl right at the very end.
I mean, he's been there from day fucking... I mean, there's only three left, right? Carol, Carl, and Rick.
Carol, see,
from the original
group. Well, yeah, I guess, yeah. Yeah.
He's still... kicking.
Yeah, I think Carol got there episode 2 or 3.
But from the original group, she's still there.
From the original group, yes. Yeah, you're right.
So, I mean, and Carl, it makes sense for Carl because, I mean, the dude learned a lot.
On top of that, I think Carol's going this season.
Think so?
I think Carol's done this season.
What do you think about, like, this next episode? Do you think another person goes?
No, not right away.
Man, why not?
I don't think so. I think they're going to leave it kind of maybe towards the midseason, maybe somebody will go. This is a big, like, two big deaths.
Nah, man.
And I think they're going to let it stew on everybody for a little bit up until the midseason.
Nah, they just start the pot. It's time for some more fucking spice.
I do think that sometime this season, Carol's going to go, though. Carol's going to be the one to go. She's, like, lost it already. Like, she's lost that fight in her. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But anyway, so, yeah. I mean, we love the episode. As you can tell, this was a big topic for us to talk about.
Yeah.
And we could probably pick it apart still.
Yeah.
And when the next episode airs, and, you know, when we next have a podcast, we're going to be talking about the next two episodes, I think.
Yeah.
By that time, right?
Probably every episode.
Yeah. For all we know, maybe the next episode of the podcast is probably going to just be Walking Dead. Yeah. Like, completely.
I forgot. I was going to... You know what? I was going to bring my little Negan, my little Pop Negan. If you guys follow us on the Facebook page, I posted him up. If you guys are ready for what's going on, what's going down tonight. And I was like, I was thinking, man, I want David's got his Lucille bat over here.
Rabbit.
I was like, put it here, you know, and let's put little Negan up here and everything. Man,
Negan.
I went upstairs. I got an Elvira Pop.
Oh, Elvira?
I came upstairs.
Mistress of the Dark?
Elvira and Negan were going at it.
What?
Yes.
Like, bop, chicka, bop, bop?
Yes. Negan was popping it, man. He was popping
it. Pop it open.
And, so there it is right there. The seal. No blood, no meat came with it or anything like that. Oh, here goes Daryl's eye.
Here goes Daryl's eye.
No, not Daryl. Glenn's eye, man. But, yeah, I was thinking, man, this right here, this needed to be... You know, yeah. Out and about, right in front of everybody.
And it was funny because, you can tell now. But I was kind of contemplating, like, pulling that out while I was watching The Walking Dead. I was like, that kind of makes me seem like I'm hugging a teddy bear. Just like, oh, my God. But anyway, so, yeah, there's that. So to move on from The Walking Dead, John had a topic that he had an issue with. And he wanted to just kind of elaborate on it just a bit.
Yeah.
So, go ahead. The floor is yours, dude.
See, this is my thing right here. Is I don't like to, like, David's real quick, online or what, anything mobile, electrical, electronics. David's real quick to squash it and just say, you know, there's no point in arguing that. I love to argue. But I like to argue face-to-face. You know, I don't like sitting there and trying to type shit out or anything like that. This argument starts off in a group on Facebook. It's, I think it's called The Legends of Zelda. It's a Zelda group, okay? So they like to post up a bunch of pictures or just new topics of what the new game is coming up or something like that, you know, anything. This topic was the Nintendo Switch. Now, I was left in the dark for a little while because I haven't really caught up on what was going on. And about a week ago, Nintendo released their video.
Yeah, it was like basically a presentation video.
Yeah.
They weren't going to have like this E3 presentation or nothing like that.
Is this the second time that they avoided E3?
This is the second time that they did that, I think. Second or third time. They do all these presentation videos instead.
Mm-hmm.
And, so they showed off the what was called the Nintendo NX, and now is called the Nintendo Switch.
Switch, yeah.
Now, first off, the name.
That's stupid.
I don't dig it at all.
I think it's stupid, David.
It's not stupid, but it's kind of dumb.
You see what I mean? How you want... David. It's fucking stupid.
It's stupid, okay?
All right,
it's stupid.
Right.
It's stupid. Uh-huh. It is. I don't agree with the name. I don't like it. They basically showed you an 11-minute video.
Fucking 11 minutes, man.
Yeah, presenting the system to you. And
in scenarios that probably would never happen. Who the fuck goes to a party and wants to take your Nintendo? Okay.
Honestly, look, this is what it reminded me of. It reminded me of a tampon commercial before a game system. Where you see everybody, oh my God, guys, you know? It's like...
But you don't know what I'm consuming.
That's yeah. And that's exactly what it reminded me of, though.
Man, that party that they had on top of the ceiling, on the roof, it kind of reminded me of like Cloverfield and some asshole bringing a Nintendo system. Like,
some asshole bringing a Nintendo to, like, to Cloverfield.
Yeah, read the tag. Oh, yeah, cool. But check this out. I got this big ass screen.
So yeah, I mean, that's okay. What it basically was, they showed somebody. I think they started out with somebody on the couch playing a game. I think it was Zelda.
It was the same shit PlayStation did.
And the controller, it looked like the shape of kind of like an Xbox controller in a way. And then he stops, he pauses what he's doing, takes off the sides of the controller where, you know, your hands would be, and then walks over to the front of the TV, walks over to the console, slides it into the sides of the console, picks it up, and walks out the door with, you know, you see a big screen, and it's turned portable now. Now, the whole presentation itself, I sat there and I watched it, and I kind of had this look of, like, okay, all right, so show me more. Like, show me something that I'm going to be excited about. Never happened.
Up until like 3.5-4 minutes, it was the same shit.
And all they were doing was showing you variations of, you know, the portability and taking it on the go and playing it at home and playing it on a rooftop, like you said.
Or you can slide it into a fucking thing with a net. Then, you know, you can prop up somewhere, and you can go at it with another person.
Yeah.
Hopefully another friend of yours fucking buys this system. Or we can go double team on this shit. Wi-Fi. Hopefully there's Wi-Fi in the area, because you can't walk around with portable shit like that and fucking play it if there's no Wi-Fi.
I think we all know what happened to the PlayStation Vita. Anyway, so, yeah, I mean, what John was basically saying was, like, you know, he was unimpressed with it. And he didn't like it.
It was stupid.
I felt I was very... It was very underwhelming. You know what I mean? I didn't dig it at all. Keep going with what you were talking about.
So the argument is this. The group. Somebody didn't get it. Somebody goes, I don't understand what's going on. What? Please explain. And all I put was... that it was a worthless... concept, console, whatever.
See, John doesn't sugarcoat shit. That's the thing.
Enough said, period. You know what I mean? And of course, the internet is out there for everybody to fucking chime in. Now, chime in all you want. I'm going to chime right back. And you want to call it troll? I just call it me being a dick or an asshole. All right? You answer.
Or a dick and an asshole. That laugh, that giggle.
Well, okay, look. If you're gonna say something stupid, then you're really gonna get a good, like, I'm gonna give you a smart ass remark back. If you give me a dumb ass fucking answer, I'm gonna give you a I'm gonna give you a straight up answer, okay? So a lot of people get offended with a lot of things that I say. Apparently, a lot of people got offended in that group, okay?
Okay, look, let's just call it what it is. John's a bit of a troll. He is.
Well, yeah, that's a new way of saying, oh, I'm an asshole, okay? But, and this went on for a while. Like, people were like, the argument was about graphics and stuff like that. I'm like, how could it not be about graphics? You know, and I was explaining to David a little while ago that, you know, when N64 came out, no, I'm sorry, GameCube. When GameCube came out, man, they rocked it. I mean, they, what was it, Rogue One? Rogue One, showed? Rogue One, Star Wars Rogue One, when that came out, man, it blew everybody out of the fucking water. Resident Evil, when that came out, man, blew everybody out of the water. Luigi's Mansion, right? Blew everybody out of the water. They were coming out with all these awesome games, all these badass games, you know? And a little bitty disc, awesome-ass graphics. Xbox, PlayStation, to me, they had to catch up. You know, although Xbox, PlayStation still had all these real good, you know, a bunch of good things going for them.
Yeah.
They were in the lead.
I will say that I think GameCube was right, in my opinion anyway. I think GameCube was right underneath PlayStation. PlayStation was at the top of its game at that moment.
Yeah.
And who's the other one? Xbox, I think... Xbox was probably like a third for me, anyway.
Well, they were just coming out.
Yeah, and GameCube was a good second, you know. And again, in my opinion.
Yeah.
But they were strong with the release of their titles, mm-hmm. what they had on a small disc, like you said. So it was impressive. Now, what GameCube could have done with a full disc,
yeah,
they could have gone above and beyond, but they decided, well, we don't want to do full, you know.
Let's do this. Let's do a full disc, and let's fucking take a huge step back, all right?
Yeah.
Let's take a big-ass step back. Or let's get hit in the face with fucking Lucia step back. You know what I mean? And so they come out with the Wii, you know? And everybody, to me, and this is true. If you listen to people, if you listen to a bunch of assholes that you probably know or whatever, somebody can, and if they're this good at selling you something, which Nintendo is, they can grab a pile of shit and shine it up real nice and pretty and sell it to you. You know what I mean? If you're that fucking good at selling stuff, somebody can actually do that to you. Now, what Nintendo did is that they grabbed this pile of shit and shined it up really pretty for you and everything.
I took it straight out of your candy.
And they sold it to
everybody. I had to go for that opportunity. I'm sorry.
I'm happy you did. That was a good one. But, you know, and what did they do? They gave us a fucking remote, and they gave us a nunchuck.
Yeah.
And you had to have both to play the motherfucker. And so this means that we had to go out and buy two more pieces of accessories, right, for a fucking game.
Yeah, and you know, and when I remember when it came out, I was like, okay, this is cool. It's like, it feels like virtual reality, kind of like interactive.
We're going to make you entertained.
But it was the hardest thing to use to play a Zelda game.
Oh, it was annoying.
And I hated it so much. Like, with a passion. I was like, fuck this shit. Like, literally, like, 5 or 10 minutes in, I'm like, I'm not playing this.
I've never played Skyward Sword because of that.
Yeah, I know. Like, a lot of people haven't.
Like, I am waiting 6 more years in the future, so they remake that fucking game on another...
It'll probably be less than 6 years, John.
All right. And then I'll play that bitch on a regular fucking... you know, on a regular control. But this is the thing right here, is that they... To me, because some prick already fucking said, well, that's your opinion. Of course it is. It's my opinion. You know?
And I'm sticking to it.
Man,
so so basically, I mean, you don't like what the Switch is. You don't like what it does. I'm on the same boat.
What I'm trying to get at is that I think if a company like Nintendo, if they stuck to their guns and just paid attention more to the console and just gave more time and effort to it, instead of trying to worry about picking this shit up and going with it.
I see what they're trying to do.
Then they can make Nintendo fucking great again. You know what I mean?
Don't say that. Don't pull a Trump slogan in here.
What? You said that? I have not been paying attention to the election. I didn't know.
What?
Did I say something?
That faggot said?
His
slogan is Make America Great Again.
Really? Oh, I didn't know.
Anyway.
I didn't know.
Man. It's fine. I don't care. But
I didn't know.
But my point is, you know, I hate that what they're trying to do. To me, in a business sense, what I see that what they're trying to do is cut costs. They're going to be like, okay, we don't have to do a portable device this generation. All we have to do is make a console that can be portable. So we don't have to do a 3DS.
They're going
to
fucking make
them. You know what I mean?
They're going to make them, and they're going to make four variations of them.
It's like, okay, what you had said that somebody had said in that group was that, oh, well, the Wii, they made enough money with the Wii and the Wii U.
Oh, my God.
Where they don't even have to worry about sales for the Nintendo Switch. That's a fucking lie.
That is the dumbest shit I've ever heard.
Kid, get your facts straight.
I wasn't a kid either.
Well, dude, get your facts straight. Because, you know, honestly, the Wii sold a lot. Yeah. Everybody bought a Wii because of what it was, because it was a new type of thing. And price.
Yeah.
And then they did, like, the Wii Mini and all that other things, you know?
Yeah. Wii Mini was the Mario version.
When they did the Wii U, they were hurting as far as sales go. They had to try their best to, like, literally, they didn't even sell, they sold maybe a fourth of a fraction as the Wii did for the Wii U. And even when I bought my Wii U, people were telling me, like, why? Why'd you buy a Wii U?
I got the same,
thing. And I'm like, because it's fun. Because I still think Nintendo games are fun.
They are.
You know, they are a fun situation. Or a fun thing to play on your free time. When you don't feel like playing this deep, serious games. You know what I mean?
They're fun. Look, I came over to David's house, and I played the Wii U for the first time. I was sold. All right? I kid you not. Within a week later, did I not go buy one?
I went and
bought one.
And I'm not going to lie. I still love Nintendo.
Yeah.
I still love Nintendo. So I don't want people to think that we don't, or that, you know, we're just trying to hate on them, whatever. I still love Nintendo. But to me, the Switch is going to be, I hope it doesn't go the way of the Virtual Boy did. I'm serious. where they presented this like package of, look at this new innovative thing that we did.
Yeah, and all it did was hurt everybody's eyes.
And then it killed them business-wise.
It did.
You know what I mean? So they need this system to sell. They do, without a doubt.
Yeah.
I hope that they give enough. I mean, it's not a complete like bomb to me where I'm like, I hate it. I'm not gonna be able to play it. You know, but I just don't like what they're putting out with it right now. Like, the presentation, it just didn't impress me.
Well, dude, I mean, think about it. The Wii U and Nintendo right now rocks a bunch of fucking powerhouse names. They have a lot of names behind the Nintendo name. And they have not even used them on Wii U yet. And here they are coming out with the new system.
And the thing is that, again, I'm going to talk about the size of the Switch. Whenever you put it in portable mode and you take it on the go, it's just as big as the Wii U gamepad.
Yeah.
And that's not the easiest thing to carry around if you're on the go.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And so I don't see the point in that.
I was explaining this to David earlier. I'm going to tell you guys. Have y'all... I asked David this. Have you ever eaten a Pop-Tart? I'm waiting for the yeses. Yeah, we got some yeses. Anyways, so you eat a Pop-Tart. Are you confined to eat this Pop-Tart at home? No.
No.
I mean, it's portable, right? Pick it up, put it in the toaster, 2-3 seconds, pop it out, let's go.
Take off, yeah.
Right? Pop-Tarts came out with, and maybe some of you know about this, and maybe some of you don't. David didn't know, but they came out with this Pop-Tart called Pop-Tarts to Go.
Yeah, I remember after you started explaining, I was like, oh, okay, yeah, I do remember.
I think he came in like in a where you can break them in half.
Where it was basically like a Pop-Tart, but cut in half, two halves.
Where
you could take it on the go, and it's like, what the hell do you think a Pop-Tart is in the first place? You know, that's kind of like what you're saying. What it feels like with the Nintendo Switch, you know?
The Nintendo Switch, the way I see it is that, like, why the fuck would I want to buy a Nintendo Switch if I can just go out and buy a Nintendo 3DS?
A 3DS, you know what
I
mean?
And, like, if I wanted to play PlayStation on the go, I'd go right out and buy a fucking PSP or the Vita.
Yeah.
That's a new thing, you know what I mean? And Vita even had that same commercial where the dude was playing MLB. Yeah. Remember? And he was like, I'm going to go hit the roads in New York of all places, because
the thing
baseball
is
fucking, you know.
With that, is like you were explaining, you know, with a lot of these things, they're saying, I guess they're kind of putting out there that you got to use this Street Pass, which Street Pass is available on 3DS, where if you're close by somebody that has a 3DS, it kind of registers their signal kind of thing, you know, internally. You don't have to necessarily have Wi-Fi, but it does catch, you know, somebody close by that has one.
How many people do you see?
Exactly, though.
Yeah.
Not a whole lot. And that's where PS Vita went wrong, too, because they're like, well, we're going to give you Wi-Fi, but you got to buy the Wi-Fi on it with a contract through AT&T only. You know, and it's like, nobody used that after a while. So, I think they discontinued that service after a good while.
Like,
so,
like what? A month?
Maybe a little bit more than that. But yeah, it was 1.5.
But see,
yeah, no, you have a very valid point.
I was not sold on that shit, okay?
Right now, I am not sold on it.
No.
Show me something awesome, and then I'll make my decision.
What's up, man? Hello. How's it going? So far, everything that was said in that group, and I continue, like, this, the last thing that was said on there, and I looked, this dude was like, look, man, if you got nothing good to say about it, stop trolling, and like fuck off and move on. And I'm like, and I put on there, I did dick breath, you know, I did move on. That's why I play Xbox, and that's why I play PlayStation.
That's why I go back and play Call of Duty.
No, come on, man. No, that's, I don't always play Call of Duty. Boy. I am a Call of Duty fan, but I don't always play it. I play other stuff, too. But the thing is,
Call of Duty Black Ops 3. God. Sorry, go ahead.
Anyways, so yeah, you know, I moved on from it. But you know what? I have the systems, but they're for my family. Because, and no, this is not offense to anybody or anything. I'm not saying that Nintendo, the way Nintendo is going right now, is they're trying to capture, like, the family whole thing. You know what I mean? So, of course, it's real easy for them to catch the attention of my kids. You know? And like, these guys that are arguing with me, these are grown-up motherfuckers, too. And they're like, man, this is great for me. And I was like, I don't want you at my party if you bring a fucking Nintendo over here. I want you to come to my house.
You can't sit with us. Stop. I went there. I pulled that.
And like, you know what? I've grown up loving Nintendo, man. And if somebody actually did walk up, I'd tell them to put that shit down. For real. Just put it down.
I mean, here, look.
Here's a fucking beer.
I will say, look, to be, I guess, on the I don't want to say the positive side, but on the neutral side, I'm going to try it out.
You know what? They'd be on the right side of the controller because there's a positive on the right side of the controller.
I'm going to try it out. Most likely, I will probably buy it anyway because I do want to experience Zelda on there, even though they are going to have it on the Wii U as well. That's probably the only reason that I would buy it at this moment unless they have this badass Mario game. Which, the Mario game that they showed off does look kind of fun. I will say that.
Was it a Paper Mario?
No, it was a regular, like, 3D Mario game. And that does look kind of fun. I'm always sold on, like, straight-up Mario Brothers games. You know what I mean? Those are always fun to me. And they're cool to pick up. Like, say I'm playing, I don't know, like, a Resident Evil game.
Yeah.
A really scary Resident Evil game. And I want to decompress from the horror, and I just want to play something fun. You know, then I'll pick up a Mario game no matter what. So, you know, on that, it's like, okay, I'm sold on that. They have to give me something more for me to really be impressed with what they're putting out.
They haven't even done Metroid on the Wii U.
Yeah, they haven't.
And Metroid's a big name for that.
I would love to see a Metroid on the Wii U. I don't think that's going to happen.
Did they do one on the Wii?
They did one on the Wii. They did Metroid Prime 2. I think
That was GameCube.
Was it?
Yeah, it was
GameCube.
They didn't even do it on the Wii. See?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
And they did, I think, Metroid Fusion for, I want to say it was for Game Boy Advance for 3DS.
See?
I'm not even 100% sure. But yeah.
But you have, there's more. There's more big names that have not been
done. They just barely did a Star Fox for Wii U.
And it bombed.
Yeah. It's bad.
What's up? Who's that?
Hey, what's up? Kevin?
Alessandro 74 or something?
What's going on, man? But yeah, so that's how we feel about the Nintendo Switch right now. I mean, right now at this moment, I'm not impressed. John is not impressed. Still probably buy it anyway. At some point, I'm not going to say release day. But at some point, we'll probably buy it anyway.
We have to. I mean...
especially if they come out with a Zelda edition. What's up?
Yeah, you know.
Anyway, but yeah, so... let us know your thoughts on the Nintendo Switch and what you think about that. And then we'll go from there. First, before we get into our finale, I wanted to do a little something here. And
wait, what?
We're doing something else.
Okay.
We're doing something else, John. And John doesn't know. John has no idea what's happening right
Why?
Now.
Why?
He has no idea.
Why and I don't
kept
I know?
It, I kept it hidden for a simple and...
I'm pouring a beer.
For a simple fact and simple reason. And as you can see, he's getting scared now because I'm clearing things.
I think I know what it is.
Across the table. Now, we intended to do something today, and it didn't work out. What we were trying to do was do the one chip challenge.
It's a trap.
It is a trap. Pocky, I think the Pocky, is that the name of it? Pocky, yeah, has a brand, and they have these chips. They're individually wrapped, and it's one chip per package, and it is like the hottest chip that, yeah, you could ever eat,
made
right?
In Austin, Texas.
And I could not find them. I went searching, and I went out, and well, I searched, and I could not find
them on eBay. But
yeah,
but chip like, that was sold for $5 a piece, we're going for about $50
for one chip.
For one chip. And people had cases, and there were some of them like $500.
Yeah, exactly. Ridiculous. So I was like, that's dumb, man. And John, I even had John looking for them. And it pretty much got to the point where I was like, this isn't going to happen. I'm like, oh, well, you know, I kind of wanted to have something special for today. Today is the Bot Squad Halloween Spectacular, right?
666.
Right?
Just
66. Just 66 episodes. Not 66. But I figured, why not make my own?
What?
And this is not the one chip challenge. This is the
multiple
three chip challenge.
No, and on Saturday, exactly, man.
So yeah, okay. He has not seen these.
Wait.
He doesn't know what they are.
Over the top, David.
And I'm gonna explain what they are. Okay, first we're gonna unveil them.
Chippies?
They are chips. They are chips. Okay. You look nervous already. All right. So as you can see
what
here,
the fuck?
We have chips. All right. Now let me explain.
You smell it?
And yeah, I smell it. Let me explain to you what these are exactly. Okay. These are dangerous is what they are, John.
All right. Do they have a name?
They don't have a name
per se.
Give them
a name right now.
Give us a name. But these chips.
Close up action.
Okay, let's get a little close. As you can see there,
I'm coming.
But, yeah, so these chips.
Be careful.
Whoa. These chips are very dangerous, okay? Yeah. I will say that right now. They are dangerous. No.
Oh, it's Kevin 247.
Who's that?
I don't know. They're
okay, so these chips. These chips have... I made this myself. All right? So you know... I got in the lab, dude. And I experimented. All right? These chips have...
Smell like pizza.
Have dried... I dried up some habanero peppers. Dried up some ghost peppers. Got some red chili powder.
Uh-huh.
Or, I'm sorry, red pepper powder.
Uh-huh.
There's,
Man, why don't you tell me? I had a lot of beer already.
Yucateco, extra spicy hot sauce.
Murder.
And some Diablo sauce from Taco Bell. But on top.
I don't mind Diablo sauce.
It's pretty
Bell,
good.
Yeah.
But I just kind of put that like a little, oop, oop.
All right.
At the end. Okay, so we are going to try to eat at least three chips.
Three?
Three. This is the three chip challenge. Because the one chip challenge was made from Carolina Reapers, which is the hottest pepper right now at the moment.
So you know what? We're going to have three? We're going to have extra chips.
We will have extra
chips.
So
this is what we'll do. Whatever we don't eat, we package up and we sell it.
I thought you were going to be serious.
The Baka chip.
But, so yeah, I mean, this is kind of, you know, what
so
we're
doing
right now. We're doing this.
Okay, I'm going to grab this one.
We're doing this.
Okay.
Okay.
It smells like pizza.
It does kind of smell good.
At first, when he unveiled it, it smelled strong, but it's kind of gone and everything.
So,
I don't know.
All right. So, you ready?
Yeah. Are you for real? This has all that stuff you said?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Okay. It does. You ready? One.
Are we eating them or are you going to let me eat it?
No, we're eating.
Okay.
We are both.
Clink.
Clink. One, two.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but I'm trying to get it down.
That's where it burns when it goes down.
It's not so bad right now.
I got it down. It burns.
Just two and one?
Wow, already.
Okay. It creeps up on you. I hadn't tasted them. Oh, okay. Oh. I probably should have brought a bucket.
Yeah. I almost threw up.
Oh, shit. I don't know. Here. Use that if you need to.
Fuck.
I don't know. Okay. All right, that's the one.
No.
Go get a cup or bucket then or something. Okay. So we got one down. It's pretty bad. It's not as bad as eating the fresh ones.
Dude, no, that's brutal.
Really?
That's brutal.
Oh, so again.
It burns like just directly.
It has habanero peppers. We're eating three, possibly.
My eyes are like water.
So this has habanero peppers, ghost peppers, red chili peppers. God. Okay. You gotta at least eat another one.
Bring a bucket.
Okay.
I'm gonna throw up, dude.
You better keep them entertained. You better keep them entertained.
What do you want me to do?
I don't know. Start dancing.
I just didn't.
All right. We've had straight up ghost peppers on here, fresh cut and everything. And we've had habaneros.
You should have on it, but
I know, I didn't even know this was going to happen. So this is just a surprise to me and you, man. I'm fucked. We're both in the same boat. That's not a bucket, David.
It's a cup.
It's a big cup. Oh, shit.
All right, so this is what's going on. Oh. We have two more fucking chips to eat. I think I'm going to put both chips on top of each other.
At least two chips.
At least.
If you can do more, do more.
No.
Oh,
that shit needs to be wrapped up and sold.
Oh.
All right.
I think I did pretty good.
Yeah, you did. My hiccups have stopped, but the fucking heat is still there.
Oh. Okay.
So, two more.
Oh.
I'm not doing two. I'm going to do one more and I'm done.
One more and you're done?
One more and I'm done, man. I thought this was my beer.
Oh, my God. It's a three-chip challenge, though, John. Can't disappoint the people. Are you trying to gargle your beer?
Yeah, I'm trying to, like, let it sit. Don't give me that shit, David. I'm getting the middle one. This one doesn't look like it has much.
Oh, you'd be surprised. Oh.
I think it's okay. The Taco Bell sauce that's doing it.
Yeah, the Taco Bell sauce out of all of them. Hold on. I'm not ready yet.
Oh. I am.
Oh, son of a bitch.
No.
Oh.
That's not happening.
Oh, my God. It tastes savory at first. It tastes kind of good.
Yeah, the chips are good.
Oh, but then it hits. Or the seed or something. Yeah. Yep, seed.
Like we said earlier, I'm a man. I'm gonna... Oh.
Oh, my God. Happy Halloween, everybody.
Why don't you tell me this shit?
Damn! Look at... Because it was a surprise.
You know what? It'd be cool, like, if you surprised me with, like Nintendo's new fucking system.
You want the Nintendo Switch?
Oh, my tongue, bro.
I would rather eat this than have a Nintendo Switch right now.
Hmm. Dude, let it sit there. All right, I can do the third
one. Now, any?
Yeah, I can do the third
one. Okay. Now, I know that we do a lot of these hot pepper things.
This one's the worst.
This one's pretty bad.
This one's good.
This one's pretty bad. But I think the Nets, we're going to have to end it and not do any more after the Carolina Reaper. We're going to have to do a Carolina Reaper, John, at some point. Ooh, let me get a drink of beer real quick, and then we'll do the third one.
Just so you guys know, before we end, we're going to do the t-shirt giveaway.
Can you?
Yeah, I could do it. I could do it. My tongue is fucking burning now like crazy.
Oh, my God.
Okay. I just felt my nose just clear up.
This one isn't so bad.
Fuck you, man.
It's not. Look, compared to the other ones.
Well, I'm going to pick that one.
No, I want to pick. You pick that one.
No.
That's what you gave me, you shithead.
Oh, shit. The audio people, they're listening here, like,
what the hell's going on?
Damn.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, damn. All right, so we're completing this challenge right now.
Right here.
Oh. What the fuck was that?
That was a big old piece of pepper. I don't want that.
You have one on there? No?
Yeah, right
there.
Yeah, take it off.
No! Oh, I did
that. Oh. I got to remember not to rub my eyes with that finger.
One. Two, three.
No, wait, no! No, wait.
All right.
No, he's scared. No.
Just wait.
Why?
Because I'm not ready yet.
I want to get this
I'm not ready yet, John. I'm not ready.
Okay. The burning, like the throat burning,
it's starting to subside a little bit.
It's just it's in my mouth, man.
Yeah, like I said, it's different than eating a fresh pepper.
I got a cut now. I can feel it burn as shit, like right here.
This is way different than eating just a fresh pepper itself. You know what I mean?
Man, okay. You know when this killed my buzz too.
Cool. One. Two.
Three.
No! No, way.
Come on, man.
Hold on. Three.
You jerk.
Need it.
That one was hotter.
Yeah. Oh, my God. This one's the hottest shit. It's one of those moments. Oh, it's one of those.
No, because the more you.
It's one of those moments, though, where you start chewing it and it tastes kind of good. And it's probably the Taco Bell sauce.
And it totally goes away.
And then it just goes like downhill from there.
The more you talk, the more it burns.
Mm-hmm. This is not talk. I want to talk like this for about the next 20 minutes. Shit.
Rub your tongue across your teeth.
I don't want to.
Okay, I did.
This is bad.
The last time I blew chunks, I did it in a buddy of mine, his sink. And he had just cleaned the dishes, and I fucking
blew. The last time I almost blew chunks was here on this podcast when we did the cat food Oreo. Oh, get the cup.
No.
Chunk. Yeah, the cat food Oreo the last time. I still, to this day, I have not eaten another Oreo since that time.
I have not eaten it.
Whoa! You crying?
Yeah, cat food Oreo.
Yeah, cat food Oreo.
Go check
look
it out.
Look it up.
It's a podcast. It's the Oreos of Doom.
Yes, look it up on youtube.com/sinmedievian. Oreos of Doom is there.
That's...
Son of a bitch. Okay. Oh, I know this is gonna burn, but
dude, look at it. Mess with my voice. It went down. You hear that?
Yes.
Oh, James.
He's crying. He got tears in his eyes. I'm pretty much on the verge of it.
I got it. I got it.
I'm gonna
wash it down. Hold on.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, another idiot idea by David Cantu.
You've had three so far.
Three for three. I'm on a roll. I don't know. On the right? So that's me?
Yeah.
Is it?
He's saying I'm going to die.
Oh, you probably are going to die.
I'm taking David's beer.
Oh, my God.
Where's your beer?
Right here?
I didn't rub my eye. Why does it burn?
You'd be surprised. Don't rub your nuts.
Here. I'm good. No, you got a hat.
Okay. Oh, my God.
No, dude, we had... He didn't even... Oh, I... Check this out.
I don't like milk.
They brought milk the last time. If you watch the Orioles of Doom episode, hold on. I gotta talk
and take a moment. Every time you talk, it burns more.
They brought milk for us, and David had a cup, and he didn't want to drink it. He was spitting in it, and then go back and watch it. Monica is his wife. She takes a cup and pours milk in it.
And you drank it?
I drank it.
You drank my spit milk?
I watched it again. I was
shit.
Fuck peach fucking.
Peach flavored milk? No, where do you live? No offense. That's gross. I'm going to have to go back and watch the Oreo.
I drink your shit. I drink it. I'm like, I don't know, man. Because my mom was...
You didn't taste it, whatever.
Still tastes like shit.
Oh, my God. I just got...
All right. Let's do this.
You do it.
Okay. So, as you guys know that we, on our last podcast 2 weeks ago...
2 weeks ago... You sound like you have this hardcore Spanish accent.
Did I?
2 weeks ago.
He's not crying.
I'm about to.
Alright, so 2 weeks ago we did a podcast and we did another t-shirt giveaway, okay? And this t-shirt was... forgive me and bear with me too, please.
Yes. But please watch all the way through because somebody's going to be announced to win.
Yeah, but we're giving this t-shirt away right here. This poof. We're giving that away.
Awesome shirt.
Yeah. It's brand new, never been worn t-shirt right here. An extra large, by the way. So if you're a chick or whatever and you want to, you know, use it as a nightie.
Oh, like a sleep shirt. Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
What's up?
Or if you're a dude, whatever.
And you want to use that sleep shirt?
Yeah, what's up? Oh, man, hold on. I'm talking too long.
With every word that comes out, it burns more.
Yeah, it's just totally easy on mark.
Oh my God.
Anyways, so what I did yesterday, if you follow us on Facebook, Facebook what?
Facebook.com/BotSquadPodcast.
If you did, what I...
Oh man, it's coming all out.
Yeah, we're leaking out of every orifice right now. Okay, I don't want to touch the...
Please don't shark.
Stuff. No. But what I did is I went on ahead and I added a bunch of Spidey stuff. Because, so you get a Spidey koozie.
That's a cool koozie. Why didn't you tell me about that before, John?
Yeah, come you know on, what? Because I know your ass would have stole it. David likes to stay.
Son of a damn, okay?
I like it. And David steals.
Man, we'll take it out of the contest.
You got a Spidey wristband. And then you have a Spidey keychain. And then some Spidey pins.
What is that? Oh, some man. Pins,
yeah. You know what? I didn't want to show this to your boy.
I know. He would have been crazy. Oh, my God. Yeah.
His son would have went crazy.
Yeah.
Now you got a patch going on, a Spidey patch.
Oh, that's really cool.
Yeah. Hold on.
No. Really cool, though. I like that.
Yeah.
Yes, man. Thank you.
So, right here, in Secret Wars, Hobgoblin little bobblehead, right?
Oh, shut up. You serious?
Yeah.
So nice.
That on top of a, no.
Okay. Right. God. Okay.
That on top of a comic book.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
A little comic book.
From the Marvel Collector Corps, right?
Yep.
Cool. So awesome.
That's all thrown in on
On the giveaway as
on
well.
On the giveaway, yeah. So not only do you get the t-shirt, but you get all these little trinkets and everything.
So now we're going to go ahead and pick somebody. We are Twitch streaming, actually. Twitch.tv/CinemaDeviant. Check us out.
And what I'm doing right here is that everybody who's gone to our page and liked and shared.
Oh, wow. That's a pretty good amount of people, dude.
Their names are here. I'm going to push a button. The names are going to scroll.
And randomly one will come up. And
David's going to pick okay. one. And that's going to be our winner, okay?
That's a pretty good amount of people. Okay. Yeah. All right. Cool. All right. So go ahead and roll it. Press the button.
All right. And there you go.
Okay. Who's that? Armando Avila Jr. Armando Avila Jr. has won.
He's going to win the prize pack. T-shirt and everything. Armando Avila Jr.
Armando.
All right, Armando.
Sorry for mispronouncing your last name.
Are you feeling better?
A little bit. It's still hot as fuck. And I'm sure I still have stuff stuck in my teeth. You should try another one, John.
No, we're done. And you know, we actually should package these up.
You know what?
And sell them.
Okay. If anybody wants one, I don't guarantee their freshness. I will say that right now. We have five. Okay? We have five leftover chips. I do not, and by any means, guarantee their freshness. I will bag each individual one up.
I will
up
help you.
In a Ziploc baggie, okay? And we will send them out. If you want one of these chips, you know what?
You know what? I'm happy you're doing this because I was thinking this, and I figured you were going to shoot me down.
If you want one of these chips, subscribe to the Bot Squad Podcast Facebook page, okay? And make it
known.
Yes, comment down below. We'll take a picture of these chips, okay? We'll comment.
Right here, right now.
We will like I said. I'm sorry. I'm getting thrown off because I'm still like. We'll take a picture of these chips. Post a picture. Comment down below. And then we will pick a winner. Well, we'll pick the first five people, I guess.
Bam.
How about that?
There's five chips. The first five people.
First five people to comment that they want one.
Oh, shit.
We will contact you guys. Send us your address. And we will send them out to you. Again, I do not guarantee their freshness. I don't. They may be stale by the time they get
it.
I don't know.
By the time you get it, yeah.
I don't know. But if you do want to experience this chip that, again, homemade. By yours truly.
They're fucking good.
Well, they're good, but they're hot good. Then do that, and then I want you to, how about we have them send us a
record
video.
Record themselves and then send it to you.
Send us a video of you trying this chip, and then post it to our Facebook page.
Yeah.
How about that? Again, facebook.com/BotSquadPodcast.
Dude, touch your teeth. Up.
I don't want to.
Oh, but my God.
With all that being said, we're going to go ahead and end this episode of the Bot Squad Podcast. Thank you guys for tuning in and watching and listening. I know. I know. It's the hotness, okay? thank you guys for tuning in, watching, listening, all that stuff, subscribing. Thank you to the new YouTube subscriber that just commented right now that he was the 1,291 YouTube subscriber, Kevin 742, something like that. Sorry, I'm sorry.
Hey, man. Thanks, dude.
Thank you so much. Visit CinemaDeviant.com for all your movies, news, reviews, trailers. Facebook.com/CinemaDeviant as well. YouTube.com/CinemaDeviant. Subscribe to that page. This podcast will be going up on CinemaDeviant, on the YouTube CinemaDeviant channel. So subscribe there as well. And then it's always there to view on Twitch, twitch.tv/CinemaDeviant. Twitter, @CinemaDeviant. Snapchat, CinemaDeviant. Instagram, CinemaDeviant. Tumblr, love you, Tumblr. Tumblr.com/CinemaDeviant. John, what are your social networks? I'm sorry. I'm like still all around everywhere. I'm, you know what? It's like this is giving me a high now.
Yeah.
I'm all hyped up now.
Yeah.
What's going on?
You know, doesn't it release like a bunch of
endorphins?
Endorphins and stuff
like
that?
I think
that?
So. Something like that. Anyway, go ahead.
But anyways, Instagram and Twitter. Oh, I know David's going to correct. Instagram and Twitter, BotBang94. Instagram and Twitter. Instagram is BobBang94. See? Twitter is
Spawn94AEW. Yes. Okay, so Snapchat and Twitter is Spawn94AEW, and Instagram is BobBang94.
Yes.
See what I mean?
Okay, all right.
And just make sure you go to our Facebook page and like us, share us, and all that stuff. And then...